From Emmitsburg, Maryland at Mount St. Mary's University, you're tuned in to the Northeast Conference Women's Lacrosse Championships on ESPN3. In our second semifinal today, the Mountaineers play host to the Bryant Bulldogs.
Petito, a couple of ticks better than that. Second best in the land, but it's going to be Bryant that strikes first as Emily Diaz puts it in, a low shot. Mount sells into the attack. Jordan Groover plays it behind X. It's Butler to the middle. Butler with the shot, and she scores. Five to one in favor of Mount St. Mary's as Jordan Butler set it up.
It was beautiful to watch, and those skip passes, they're just, you got to work your way around sometimes in women's lacrosse.
Kinsella around the back for Elena Pagnotta, who finds Carly Miller, who buries one from GLE. Just came right around the crease and shoved it down in the corner behind Kappa Sujin. And it's a 9-2 lead for Mount St. Mary's.
So many different ways to beat a goalkeeper. And Kappa Sujin has not seen that shot yet from behind X. And first time she sees it, goes between the five holes, scores.
So Jess DeMayo's been held without a point. Outstanding senior, two-time NEC Offensive Player of the Year in 2017 and 2018. Starts in, got closed off, sent it back, and the shot and a goal for Emily Diaz, her second of the game, and the assist to Jess DeMayo. Big credit to Mount St. Mary's defensive unit and the way that Jordan Groover continues to dominate in the draw circle.
Kind of see why she's freshman of the year in the NEC, but still, this is an impressive performance.
No kidding. She's gone toe-to-toe with Lauren Britton. Oh my God, she should have shot that. Inside a shot and another goal for Elena Pagnotta. That's her third, and it is a 10-goal lead for Mount St. Mary's. Mount St. Mary's has 19 shots on goal, and 15 of them have gotten through. 24 total shots. I mean, as a team, shooting close to 70% is just terrific.
Well said, Joe, and Coach Skelchok pointed it out. We need good quality shots, and they're getting them.
Bierogel sent it inside to Taylor Carhart, and her shot went high, backed up by Mount St. Mary's. Right back inside, a quick stick goal for Elena Pagnotta, her fourth of the day, tying her season high, and it's a 16-4 lead for Mount St. Mary's. Down on the ground, 10 seconds to go. Dees scoops it up for Mount St. Mary's. Fires it ahead in the double team, knocked down by Emily Davis. Can't save it inbounds. It's Bryant ball, but it doesn't matter. The St. Mary's Mountaineers are headed to the Northeast Conference Championship game for the first time since 2013. As Mount St. Mary's defeats Bryant by a final, running away 18-4. We get set to send it down to the fields. Sending by Jamie with our player of the game, Jordan Butler.
We're back here with Jordan Butler from Mount St. Mary's. What a season you've had, Jordan, shattering records. What do you attribute this season, such a great season, to?
Just hard work and my teammates. Like, I couldn't do anything without them. And yeah, just everything, my coaches, my family, you know, everyone. Everyone helped me.
Get the job done. What are you looking forward to on Saturday, your first championship game?
I'm looking forward to a really exciting game, some good competition. Wagner, like, we only beat them by two in the regular season. So, you know, playing them again, it's going to be interesting.
Yeah, it will be. We're looking forward to it. Congratulations on a great year. Thank you so much. Jordan Butler, ladies and gentlemen, of Mount St. Mary's. We're going to get a chance to talk with Lauren Skelchok here, the winning coach today, in a moment. Come on in, Lauren.
Hi.
Hi, how are you? I feel as if we need to say this was a statement win by you in this program. Can you talk a little bit about what this means to you?
I think it's just awesome that we're here in this atmosphere. We have a ton of fans here. We had a lot of other teams supporting us. It's just great that we get to do this, not only with our team, but with the men's team along our side. Just a lot of Mount community that went into all of this. So I'm just really proud of everyone who's involved.
That's outstanding. Let's look ahead a little bit, just a little bit, because I know how you are. On Saturday at noon, we're going to go up against Wagner for the second time around. Give us a little smidge inside your head. What are you thinking?
Super athletic. It's always a battle between us and Wagner, and obviously just moving into this championship game, I'm sure there's going to be adjustments being on both sides, so we just have to be ready to go. But really proud of our team and the resiliency that we have shown over the past couple weeks. I'm just feeling really confident.
Fantastic. Enjoy this one. We'll see you on Saturday.
All right, thank you.
Congratulations. Back up to you, Joe.